In the systems biology and mathematical modeling group at the University of La Laguna, we've been working on issues of biomedical interest for more than 20 years. And in order to do that, we use an approach called systems biology. Systems biology is a relatively new method, but it's important in current biological research. The starting point is a view that pathologies, such as malaria, can only be studied, understood and resolved if we see living beings holistically, as systems of interrelated elements, interacting with one another and the environment. If we take this perspective, what becomes clear is that living elements are extremely complex, both in terms of structure and as a result of the number of components and the multiple interactions that take place among them. On top of this, we have another level of complexity because living beings are constantly changing, adapting and readjusting to the changeable environment in which they live. But how can we come to understand and control major problems such as malaria? The systems biology response is to incorporate the available experimental information into mathematical methods capable of describing, predicting, and controlling the disease's behavior. Malaria is a disease which is transmitted through the bite of mosquitoes, infected with a parasite, the plasmodium, and it affects over 500 million people worldwide. There is no vaccine for the disease, and the available treatments are only partially effective. In our group, we want to contribute to the search for treatments by using the systems approach. In order to do this, after we've brought together and selected the available information about a specific phase of the plasmodium's life cycle in the human body, we build a mathematical model capable of reproducing the behavior of some of the key components responsible for malaria. This model allows for the identification of those processes essential for the progression of this disease. We realized that if we were capable of intervening in some of these processes that we call the target, the infection and the symptoms of malaria would disappear. In fact, the few therapies that are currently used act in one of these target processes, but the most interesting thing is that the model helped us to discover other processes that have never been considered by other researchers looking for new therapies. As is usually the case in model-based searches, there were some surprising solutions. For example, we discovered that the disease goes into remission much earlier if the immune system does not attack one of the forms of the parasite. It's a counterintuitive solution, and one that common sense would never suggest. Besides, this solution does not develop resistance on the part of the parasite, a hugely significant fact, since this is why the available treatments are progressively losing their efficacy nowadays. The major problem of the pharmaceutical industry in our time is that the search for new medicines, essentially based on testing products more or less randomly, is a process that is gradually becoming more lengthy and more expensive. The proposal based on the building of models is more rational and reduces the time and the costs involved. This will have a positive effect on the availability and the accessibility of new therapies for the affected population without developing resistance and thereby improving their efficacy. More than 500 million people will potentially benefit from this solution, primarily children who are particularly vulnerable as a result of immune deficiency to malaria, especially in sub-Saharan Africa and Southeast Asia, where it has been found that medicines are losing efficacy because the parasite is becoming resistant. The next logical step in the research that we've started would be to explore the different molecules in which the processes identified as the target act. Our results have already been published and they're available to any research group interested in continuing the work where we have left off. Ideally, our proposals would be taken up by laboratories interested in the development of medicines and in providing people everywhere with access to these new anti-malarial therapies.